Take a look at this picture. Know what it is? Of course you do. It's a galaxy. Galaxies like this have been a familiar sight since the advent of telescopes powerful enough to see them. For decades now, we've been treated to varied and often beautiful images of these distant and massive objects. And with their distinctive spiral arm structure, they've become an easily recognisable sight. But why do galaxies look like this? Let's take a look at how the spiral structures form and why they're that particular shape. The first thing to know is that not all galaxies are this shape. Many don't have spirals at all. A lot of galaxies, so-called elliptical galaxies, have no spiral structure and are just featureless disks. So why do some galaxies have these arms and others not? I'm going to demonstrate with a simulation. With the aid of CGI and some computer code, I'll create a galaxy and show how the spiral arms form. First, let's start with some empty space. I'll add a grid for scale. Each square on this grid is 10,000 light years. Now let's add some stars. I've written some code to place 3,000 stars distributed in a disk. Some galaxies contain over a trillion stars, but my computer can't handle that, so we'll just use 3,000. The stars are more densely packed towards the centre, which is the standard layout for a galaxy. But to behave like a galaxy, these stars need to orbit around the galactic core. I've simplified the calculations for speed, but the end result is a computer simulation that will animate this galaxy. And now, with the rules programmed in, let's set it running. This simulation is running at about 60 trillion times normal speed, so around 2 million years per second. Here we can see the stars moving around the galaxy. The outer stars take around 300 million years to do a full orbit, the same as in our Milky Way. The inner stars, though, moving around on much smaller orbits, go around in much less time. I've made the stars follow simple circular orbits, but this isn't generally the case in a real galaxy. And if we leave this simulation running, nothing much will change. The stars will keep moving around the galaxy, which will retain its largely featureless shape. Or at least, they'll keep doing that until something disturbs the galaxy. And galaxies frequently get disturbed. Many of them exist in groups with neighbouring galaxies close by. These other galaxies may often pass close by each other or even merge, and these gravitational interactions are how the arms form. I'll demonstrate this by putting a large mass near our galaxy. This would usually be another galaxy, but to keep it simple here, I'm going to use a black hole. We'll put it in orbit 200,000 light years from the centre of our galaxy. Okay, let's unpause the simulation and see what happens. And we'll speed it up a bit too. The black hole is exerting a pull on all the stars in the galaxy, but it's not an equal pull. The amount of force each star feels depends on its distance from the black hole, and that's going to be different for each star. The stars on the same side as the black hole get more pull, and the ones on the far side get pulled less. The result is that the galaxy gets stretched out of shape. The stars were following circular paths around the galaxy, but the pull they feel from this black hole is gradually distorting their orbits. And, as if by magic, the arms have appeared, and our galaxy now takes on the classic spiral shape. So what happened there? How does the influence of this new mass produce this spiral shape? Let's look at those orbits again. As we saw before, the orbits these stars were following were circular. After the black hole has passed, their circles have been distorted into ellipses. This alone wouldn't produce arms, we'd just end up with our galaxy stretched out a bit. But as well as stretching the orbits, the disturbance also rotated them, and the inner ones got rotated more than the outer ones. This distortion has caused the orbits to spread apart from each other in some parts of the galaxy, In other places, though, the orbits have got closer together, becoming bunched up. So it's the bunching together of the star's orbits that creates the spiral arms, and the separation of the orbits in other places that creates the gaps between them. And so the galaxy ends up with its classic spiral shape. But why does this spiral structure persist? Since the inner stars are orbiting the galaxy much faster than the outer ones, you might expect the spiral to get wound up tighter and tighter like a clock spring, twisted out of all recognition. This doesn't happen though, and it's because the arms of the galaxy aren't actually made of stars. They're just high-density regions where stars pass close together. This means that the stars move independently of the arms. Let's follow a star to see how this works. As you can see, the star isn't fixed in an arm or a gap, but instead moves between them. It's in an arm for a while, and then it's in a gap. So the arms of spiral galaxies are like density waves, which stars move through and get closer together, and then out of again, where they spread back apart. And this is why the arms can last such a long time. Even though the stars themselves don't stay in the arms, the paths that they follow retain their new shape. But what if we remove the black hole from our simulation? Let's take it away and see what happens. With the black hole no longer disturbing the galaxy, those spiral arms will gradually fade as the stars, interacting with each other, start to erode the spiral structure. And this is why some galaxies have no arms at all. Galaxies with no close neighbours, perhaps because they absorb them, will revert eventually to a featureless shape and become plain old elliptical galaxies.